welcome to another instance of the Daily Market Recap on Successful Trading's channel, featuring number one, the best day trade stock right now in the markets; two, an update on our current holding and position; and then the big elephant in the room, the earnings season has started. Without any further ado, let's go ahead and dive in. All right. The best day trade stock of the moment. This question was asked on Saturday live session that we had on Successful Trading's channel. So if you were not part of, you were not able to be with us, the recording is on in the channel. So go ahead, check it out. Great questions by the subscriber who turned out, and we will be looking to doing more of those. So we answer that question without hesitation, and now we get to show you the proof. So these are the last five days trades that we took on there. This one is today, so I did a quick little math here for you, because this is one of the questions to give the newcomers an idea about potential P&L. So here I think all, if you sum all negative, do not take this one into account, because that position is pretty much, it was bought today, so still in the accounts really. So all the other negative, I think they sum up to 480, and all the positive, they sum up to 907. So this is on just 5 days. Let's say maybe just shy of doubling our investment on the best day trade stock of the moment. But what's that stock? Possibly. Oh, you have seen it already. Yes, it is Advanced Micro Device, because this stock does not know how to rest. Let's go ahead and take a look here on TradingView. This was today. So actually, let's start with the daily view of AMD. This is what AMD has been doing, folks. In terms of average daily range, aka or average true range, let's go here quickly on FinWiz. I want the chart of it instead of just me telling you, oh, that's the number. I mean, that number, that the ATR is $3.2 in average over the last 14 days. But I want to show you the chart of the ATR. So for that, let me quickly go and change my settings on here. It should already be like that. So let's see, I want the ATR average range. Thank you. So update. I think this is only on the, you need to have the elite version maybe to do this. I'm not sure. Yeah. So yeah, since let's say mid-February, the average true range on AMD has been insane. So it has been insane, meaning this thing has been moving left and right. I mean, look at the candles. Yeah, since, actually, we can go all the way to here. Yeah, since February compared to here. I mean, it wasn't bad, like, don't get me wrong. But here, volatility is all over the place. I mean, they're taking it just every single day as they want. So if the market makers are going to do that, I'm not married to AMD like some of the fanatics on stock tweets or anything. Oops, did I say that loud? Okay. I trade AMD. That's what I wrote in one of the articles in early January on successfultradings.com blog. So go ahead and check it out. So this stock to me provide an opportunity for trade. So sometimes I told you on Saturday, those who attended on Saturday, the last session, I feel bad when I don't trade it, because I'm like, oh man, it's boring. It's AMD all the time. Yeah, but AMD, it should be your friend. You find a couple of stocks like this, my friend, as a beginner trader or as an accomplished trader, just stick with them. And you're going to be laughing your way all the way to the bank. So yes, and because it will help you get familiar with the support, the resistance, even the way that they like to manipulate it. Yes, there is a lot of manipulation that goes along. So the 15-minute today looks pretty much just like the whole market, right? We dumped from the get-go. Bang. But now let me show you maybe a little piece of... So let's remove this. So why will it stop here? This to me is something that's known. These guys, what they have been doing, and they did it with SPY yesterday, when we come close to filling a gap, they don't do that. They don't do that. They like to tease. So if they tease, if you knew that today, you would have gone with calls here. I didn't get that. My setup was on this move down, so on the very, and it wasn't even a big risk. It was just one contract. I sold the other contracts yesterday. So yeah, I could have made more actually. So and then they just did that. So then I think for me, my setup was somewhere here to go long. So we'll see what that gives tomorrow. And in any case, I will have an open mind to trade the best day trade stock of the moment. Okay, quickly, some of the updates on our other positions. So obviously today, with the gap down on C, we cash on the 43 puts. But I mean, for us, that was really just like an attempt to save, because remember we had that setup with a long range calls for May. We took them off because these markets cannot be trusted. This inside bar on here, I understand this thing trying to come back again, but I am not so sure. I want to see. I think there were bank prints on Bank of America today late. I want to see what they do, and then I will reconsider. So for me, I took that risk off. It wasn't much, but still, I don't like starting building a long-term position when the momentum of the stock is the opposite. I wanted to recapture the exponential moving average 20 before I become bullish again. So that was my stance on it. So we did a save with the hedge that we took on the put. So that was good. The one that really got us today was this guy. I mean, all right now, or all related stock is just. But I mean, it's still there. It's still there. So it's as if, is it there or anything? So we took off those long-term June contract that we have. We took those call off. So pretty much, I think we're just gonna shy away from this going forward. Yeah, really, that's the key. And IWM, this setup to me is almost like deja vu all over, but it's taking its time. Is doing all sort of things. I mean, room on the Bollinger Band. We would like the Bollinger Band to go above the exponential moving average 50, the green line. It's not there yet. It has time. So for us, since we got them at 9 cents, and actually, we could have actually cashed the 200% that we got the other day. We kind of knew that, but they were cheap or anything. So we're just going to be building this position slowly. So every time that they dip it down, let's say even toward Friday, let's say they dip it down below 9 cents again, we will load up. I guarantee you, we will load up. We saw that happen when this action was going on. And then by the time we got here, it was worth $2. Was it the famous 1,700%? So for those who are asking the type of P&L, yeah, go watch that video and then you will get the answer about the type that we see. So that's take us then to our third element of this daily market recap, which is the earnings for that. Let's go inside e-trade. I use e-trade. A lot of questions I've been getting about, so where do you get that other chart that show you the option position, the track of the option. Let me take the time to do that here properly. Do we have that set up? Yes, I think we do. Because, we do with a great example. Will that come up? But that's not the one. I want a closer one. Spy. This is going to show me side by side. Oh, geez. Okay, that's fine. Oh, you know what? I can do it live. Why am I bothering? Charts. Options. Sorry about that. Let me do it live and then we jump to the other one. So the question is, if you have that question, so that I can give you the answer right away, I'm just going to go to the 53 put because they were on AMD. Those are the one we sold today. So I click on here and I can get the chart of the option. And that's, to me, is actually a good indication about the direction that something going. I am very uncomfortable when a stock or a position is outside of the upper Bollinger. So I sold my position. These are the April 2023. I sold them way, way too early compared to others who would have made a little bit more. So for me, I didn't go all the way to the 280 or anything like that. I sold them 170 something. Yeah, as we saw in there. Just because, hey, But obviously, when it got here, that's your indication to take calls to go the other direction, because really this thing was just overbought. So same thing applies on the stock as on the option. You can get that indication here, and it's more precise on the option, because that's what we are buying, you and I. That's what we are trading. The stock can move a certain direction, but you know there are other parameters that they are playing, aka the implied volatility. Speaking of implied volatility, let's transition to the implied volatility of the mighty Netflix, who just released the earnings. Oh my, oh my. So take a look at this. For those in the WhatsApp group, we share this view today for education purposes so that they can take a look at it tomorrow. I'm going to take a snapshot of this tomorrow, 5 minutes into the open. These numbers are going to drop bigly. Yeah, bigly. Sorry, but they will drop. They will drop. In any case, as of now, there's not that movement. So meaning that if you bought calls or you bought puts, the market maker is just saying, ching ching, thank you for contributing to the wealth. So we don't do that. We do not partake into that. So we do not teach that. We do not, 99.9% of the time, there is no business trading. Especially not on this guy, just because these prices are ridiculous. So there is so yeah. Let's go to the call side, because everybody was yeah. The mindset was 167% for, let's say, the 4 6 year. You're gonna be spending $20 or something on calls. Really? No way, no way, no way, no way, no way, no way. So the implied volatility here tomorrow when we take it is going to be minus 50 for all of these, so for the change. So in our case, we are going to wait tomorrow to see how this thing reacts, and then we will trade appropriately. So how are we going to do that? We are going to use a piece of research that's available to our subs. So this is it. This is how Netflix behaves after each earning on the next 3 days. So we are able to see that the opportunities on the day after earning, this is after the earning has been announced, to either go calls or put. So so this is day one on the put side, day two on the put side, day three on the put side. So for us, this gives us confidence that we can chill, relax, not pay for the high implied volatility, the high premium that the market makers want all you to get in before, and taking a gamble pretty much. And then we will be able to pounce. We even today, there is some further research that was done on here that showcased the correlation. Is it this one? The correlation between what happens to Netflix and what happened to Roku. So that's something that's to trade that pair, it will be very interesting to see. So let me just give you a snapshot of that. This is it here. So Roku behavior on the day, on the 3 days after Netflix earnings. So it's difficult to read. The key thing for you is that Roku is moving on the first day that Netflix released earnings. So over the last four earnings, this is it here, 19% up on the call side, and then the most recent one, minus 14%. So it's not always bullish. Three times out of four, it was bullish, but this most recent one, it was bearish. The key takeaway is what? The key takeaway here is not so much the direction, that we can predict the direction tomorrow of Roku or anything. Is that Roku will be moving, so meaning we can day trade it confidently. Once it signal us the direction, that's what we want to be. So we will be looking, and in average here, this 19%, 4% or anything, if Roku gave you 5% on a day trade, you'll have done great. Remember, Roku was on our Sunday night watch list, right? So for those, I'm reading it here off of the note that I took, and actually let me go ahead and show you that inside of inside here. So Roku puts, if you had that on your watch list based on that signal that we briefly introduce you the inside bar on Sunday night. So Roku puts actually generated a great deal of gain today because Roku sold off like most of the markets. So which one am I featuring on here? So I'm featuring the 103 puts. Yeah, it didn't even have to go there. So the 103 puts or the 104 puts, let's chart them out. So that's where you will see. So here they are. So yesterday they were worth 20 cents or so. They went as high as $1.58. So we're talking 500%. So meaning that if you were, you will learn this, how to trade the inside bar that's come out of that report. We have a long way to go into teaching you that. By strangling them, one side actually will come ahead. And we have research that we will be sharing with you for each one of the stock, or actually for any stock of your then nature that you give us, we will be able to provide you that research. That's something to come that we will be unveiling so shortly. But just to give you a snapshot of that, Roku did that today. Who else did that today? I think, we also had NVIDIA on that list. So NVIDIA calls, they went from 30 cents to $3.60 instead of, let's check that out here and conclude on that. Well, which one am I looking at? I'm looking at the 250 puts. Yep. So here's the chart for NVIDIA for the 250 puts. 2 days after we put it, it had that signal. So here they are, 30 something cents, right? On the 20th, on Monday, so at the close, 43 cents or whatever, and then today, $3.60. So if you got them here early, that's almost a 10 bagger. No, not quite. Yeah, thereabout. Yeah, that's a 10 bagger, right there. 900% if you want. And as usual, you can use the indicator, the RSI indicator. I mean, for me, I didn't trade this. I didn't trade this, guys. That's so much. That's so many positions. As of now, I just want to illustrate the introduction. So don't go telling me there in the video that, oh, you say that, but show us. No. I mean, as of now, the price you are seeing here is the one at the close. Obviously, it closed here, but the high of the day was here. So that's another thing on there for you to take into account. So we will be diving more, spending time and unveiling those signals that we have developed over the last few years on here. So those were the highlights of the daily market recap. So in summary, we know about the best day trade stock, AMD, that is. We managed some position some difficulty this morning, C, Zoom, and AWM. And we have some setup going into tomorrow where we will be looking for Roku as a proxy to Netflix or Netflix itself, because both, but they will be the number two and number one and number two on the watch list in whatever direction to day trade them. Hopefully you come back again on this channel to get to see how we do with that. Thank you very much. Have a good day, a good afternoon, wherever you're watching from. And we're glad to have you on Successful Tradings. Bye-bye.